Hey everyone, welcome to today's live stream. Today we're going to be drawing Gon from Check Hunter. Okay. The scene that we are going to be referencing from is basically from the later art, what was the chapter? Just the insect arc, basically around the time when, Gon finds, Pito, for the first time, and he tried to get her to come save his one of his old mentors or whatever. So as you can see, I already got started on the facial features. I'm now just gonna be working on the mask. I decided to add a bit like a fist in the scene. In this scene, there is a lot of tones on the facial trying to express deep anger in this scene. So I'm gonna try to recreate that with alterations. Because in the original manga, I don't want to bash on the art style, but it could have been done better. If you had more time. Original creator of the manga, he draws obviously it's not very realistic, the light and shadows or whatever, it's tones. So I'm gonna recreate it in a way that would better suit the scene. Yes, remember to subscribe for more videos. Leave a suggestion, what I can draw for next time, in the next live stream. More of the boniness into his knuckle. To give a bit of flame. Oh, wait. A little more. Figure out where the tones are going to be for later. the best way to kneel the flame-like look is to have a short, always curved lines. You can lift this with your hand. And always have like little bits of flame in there. Falling right off of this. I decided to alter his nose a little bit so it has more dimension. I guess adding nostrils, doesn't seem to work. Actually, here's nothing in one direction. Some muscles with the shoulders. Maybe get a little crazy with the t-shirt. A little more muscles here and there. We're gonna add a little bit of lace, like stitchy detail for later. A little bit of being on another side. like to his arm hit. And shadow's gonna be okay, obviously under the neck. Not to show how to express intense emotion on his face through simple lines. I just go for minor detail on the face. Because the last one, the Hisoka one, that one turned out a little bit better. Be sure to check out the last video, the one where I drew Hisoka. Because that one had some, it had a ridiculous amount of detail. I'm gonna start, thinking, and then decide later, what might work. Look at their work on the fist. The best way to draw a fist is to remember that it's like, that it's a square. A square shape. Square like, square rectangular shape, depending on how you see it. More gorgeous than I do in my tones around this. tend to put tone like shadows in places where I believe there would be like tiny shadows would be, like for instance the knuckles. I feel like the shadow would also come from the side as well. That's why I'm saying to add to, you know, shadow here and then adding an extra set of tone so that the shadows around the knuckle are not, they don't really that it does not appear from the other set of tones that I'm applying to. Having your lines curve, like, see, like, if you were able to see what I did with the thumb, I had the lines curve so that it would curve out the thumb, like, it would look more, flat, like it was square-like, but then since I curved the line, it looks more of a natural, thumb-looking shape. do the same for around the other muscles as well. Okay, if you understand what I'm doing is the way that I separate this hand from looking like it's a part of the arm itself and keep them separate is by adding second tone onto the fist so that the tone that I have over here does not mix together with this. To work on the stitch line for the shoulder. We use the thick lines to show t-shirts. on the internet. Yeah, I think the best way to keep tone for a minute, like, really the shortest from the ear, and all the way down to, like, the back of the neck. That's what I've seen a lot of, manga artists seem to do. Them in the eyes. Maybe leave a little shine. That's some dynamic lines. Look at that, I'm here for the eye. I guess I'm still working on the hair. I'm gonna leave out the hair shine. That you normally have, because you feel like around like this hair. Thank you. the way that I'm creating these lines is by using the exact corner of his head at the local point and just going straight out from the nose. And after a while, once I hit the middle, I start changing direction. I'm just keeping a steady hand, and I'm just using the same motion. I'm maybe using my hand, I'm using my arm, and I just sort of relax my fist, my hands. So there's not a strain on my hand, my hands. So it's not about the wrist, the arm. They're still inking this thing. Maybe I'm a little slower, so the ink feels more. Direction. It didn't seem to come out a lot easier. Going in a different direction. some are sad. It's just a lot of, it's very tedious, just a lot of straight lines, but it looks really great at the end. Let's see how much time we have. Okay, we have about 40 minutes. Okay, I'll try to see if I can emulate these things. Oh wait, almost forgot the little details here, the stitching. I'm thinking I'm gonna do like a double stitch around his collar. Yeah, to get an emulate on the flames, kind of similar to the way that I was doing the sketches. So I'm trying to make the frame kind of as circular as possible, but not to, to cover up entirely the fist, because, you know, there was a lot of detail that went into the fist, so we don't want to cover that too much of it is. I think you can still see details on the fist, even though there's like a decent amount of black lines surrounding it. I might go over the original something that I did, shadows on the fist, just so that it stands out just a little more. Like a double cross hatch or a shrimp. for some reason, I felt, I don't know, this whole, I don't know what this area that, and then the nose, the lips, to see if it works. Doesn't seem to be. I'm gonna add a little collar to it. A little shadow on the collarbone. Maybe in it too. Yes. Okay, but before I finish off this live stream, you guys get a good look at the whole picture. What they were sticking around for this, long, if you've managed to stick around, to the ending of this, tutorial, like if you enjoyed, this this tutorial, feel free to check my other stuff. Feel free to check out comic Don the Mask. If you find it, pin in link below. It's a comic that I worked on. You know, you can check out this here's Volume 1. Feel free to check out Volume 2. Yeah, if it's something, if you enjoy comics or whatever, feel free to check out my stuff. Link in the description below. Volume 1, Volume 2, both available on Amazon.com or CreateSpace. Check out my Twitter. You might end up finding this this drawing. Later, I'll be with Twitter or maybe my Tumblr. I'll leave a link to that below. At some point, when I eventually do upload the image, I'll leave a link to it. Yes, thank you for coming out. Stay tuned. Remember to subscribe and then leave a comment. More videos to suggest other characters that I could draw for later. And see you guys next time. Bye!